Hello everyone, thanks for checking out Casual Toys. Today we're going to be looking at the Star Wars Black Series, Titanium Series. These are a smaller action figure. They run about $15 to $25. I was able to find mine at my local store here for about $15. Anything over $25 though, you're definitely going to be overpaying. So just be careful on that. You may be asking why this box is empty. Well, I actually did an unboxing of it and my camera stopped working. So we're going to go ahead and look at the figure and review it anyways. Here we go. It's already set up and out of the packaging. So this should be a little bit quicker. This is Kylo Ren. He comes in this action pose already and he comes with a lightsaber already in his hand. Now he does come with another accessory, which is his helmet without his hood on. Now, I personally like him with the hood on. He looks a lot better in this pose. I didn't have a problem sticking him on the base at all. There are little pegs that come in the box. And on the back of each one of these, there is another scene. We also have Obi-Wan Kenobi here and Darth Vader that we're going to take a look at. Now, each one of these characters also comes with what I like to call a swooshy lightsaber, which I'm just not a fan of at all. I don't think these look good in any of the poses. These are more like a fighting effect, but as you can see, each one, not really in a fighting stance at all. So I'm not a fan of these. That's Kylo Ren's. Here's Obi-Wan Kenobi's. Maybe if you want to use these on another action figure that you might have, these would work perfectly for that. They're not bad. I'm just not a fan. Darth Vader's is the worst, though. Look at this. They didn't even try. And it's so unbelievably large compared to the others. Look at this. And I'm not quite sure if it's just my Darth Vader figure, but I have some problems with him as well. But we'll take a look at him last. So here's Obi-Wan Kenobi. He's from the first wave of figures that I got. I really enjoy him also. I had no problems sitting him on the base at all. He sits there perfectly. His lightsaber is a little bent, but that is because of the box that I got it in. Here's the back of his. I like the shiny finish in the background. It looks a lot better in my personal opinion. So we'll set him behind Kylo. Now here is Darth Vader. Alright, let's talk about all the problems I have with Darth Vader. First off, I don't mind his pose. Mine, he doesn't really quite fit his base. You can see a big amount. Like, his chest is a lot smaller than his waist. Another bad thing about Darth Vader, he's a lot heavier than any of the other figures that I had. And his cape, it looks good, but it's so incredibly large that you can't set him on any of the back row of the pegs. If you do, the back plate falls off. So that's another downside of Darth Vader. And mine, look, he's just so heavy that he just tips. Now, I don't know if this is true for all Darth Vaders, but just be careful on that. I will show you the back of his. So when I set him up, I'm real careful with him. I'm going to actually set him back on the shelf and everything. But, yet again, you can't really... What is this made for? Who is this made for? Look at this. Anyways, let's get back to Kylo Ren. This is the original figure I was reviewing. I really like these figures. These two. But I will put Darth Vader over here. The only downside to the Titanium Series Wave, first one and the second one, is I feel like they didn't pay that close of attention to detail on all the characters. Some of the sculpts on their faces are kind of lacking. They did a great job on Kylo Ren's helmet, as you saw. Obi-Wan Kenobi looks like Obi-Wan Kenobi. It's just the other figures in the line I probably most definitely won't get, just because they don't hold the same standards as the other Black Series. I know these are a minifigure and they're a lot cheaper, but I feel like they should have at least put a little bit more effort when I feel like some figures got a little bit more love and the other ones just didn't. But anyways, that's my short review. of the Titanium series here on Casual Toys. Go ahead and leave me a comment in the section below, and we'll talk about them. Do you have the other figures? How do you like them? Do you have a problem with a Darth Vader figure? Please let me know. I'm really interested to know if anyone else is having problems with their Darth Vader. Anyways, guys, thanks for checking me out. Hope to see you.